This morning, what I'd like to do is show you the process that I use to create pieces of artwork called intuitive painting. So what intuitive painting is, it's very much like jazz improvisation. You know the rules, theoretically, but really it's about using your intuition and freeing yourself so that whatever is inside of you can come through onto the canvas. I have no idea what I'm going to paint, what it's going to look like. I'm just going to basically avail myself as a vessel and see what comes through onto the canvas. So it's going to be interesting because I have absolutely no idea what it's going to look like, but I know that whatever needs to come through me is going to manifest itself onto this canvas, and you're going to get to watch. The way I like to do my work is by starting off very general and going from general to specific. So again, I have no idea what I'm about to create, but I know that I want to utilize all the different colors of the rainbow, and I know that I want to convey a sense of light and love, as well as communication and stability. So, what I want to do here is I'm going to start. I try, since I'm using acrylic colors and acrylics, they tend to dry very quickly. So I don't put a whole lot of paint on my palette. I have just the three little blobs of paint, and I'm gonna use some water to dilute them. And then I'm just gonna work very broad. I always go from broad to specific because as I do that, I start to see things inside of what I'm painting. But really, it's just about the process. So let's see, I know I wanna... There's like no wrong in this. That's what's so good about it. I do think I wanna have like maybe the lightest area somewhere in here to draw attention, but I'm not even locked into that. We'll just see what happens. Spreading my white around. I like to do a lot of circular types of motion, especially in a clockwise manner. And the reason why I do that is because it reminds me of our different energy centers and how they rotate and they spin energy in a clockwise manner. So I just like to have my strokes that way. And usually something winds up looking like something eventually, and then I just kind of go from there. So now we have a large canvas, and the cool thing about the canvas is reminds me of how my life every day when I wake up in the morning can be a blank canvas. So it's just a matter of what will I put on it. All right, so now I'm gonna add a little bit of color. See where that comes. I'm just gonna start off real light. And then go spread it around a little bit. Ooh, I'm supposed to be starting off light. There we go. All right. Reason why I start off light instead of like diving in there with a whole lot of color is because that way if I want to paint over it, I can, and the light color will usually be a nice background color because I'll be working in different layers and the different layers kind of materialize things and give it some depth. For me, painting is another form of meditation because you can literally lose track of time while you're painting, and that's a good thing because you're just in the present, and while you're in the present, you're not worrying about the past and you're not worrying about the future. You're just enjoying the process. So there's like this mental shift that can take place, and it's very relaxing. It's very therapeutic. It's very healing. All I'm doing is just going around circles. I don't like the cycles that life takes you on. Just going around circles. I'm just being real free with it. I'm gonna do some more white. Kind of dilute everything. I feel like I'm already starting to see some things inside of my marks that I've made, which is interesting. Maybe I'll develop those things that I'm seeing. And when I think about the different colors that I'm using, generally going in this circular motion, like I said, it reminds me of how our energy centers, how they run. They run in counterclockwise. They're like spinning wheels of energy. So what I'm doing in my mind is I'm thinking about these spinning wheels of energy, and I'm just putting them on the canvas. Spinning wheels of energy. Kind of going real light on and trying to avoid that middle area, because I want this area, I do know that I kind of want that area to be the lightest part of the whole composition. So for right now, since I'm not sure what I'm going to do with it, I'm just kind of avoiding painting in that area, and I'm filling out some of the other areas. You know, I've talked to several people about this intuitive painting, and they have said things like how uncomfortable they are with painting. But what it is it's just a mindset shift. You have to, like, kind of, with this type of painting, you have to go into it with an open mind and just free yourself and just see what comes out and embrace the process and not necessarily the product. And then if you can do that, you have the joy of creating something, but then at the end of it, you can actually be pretty amazed with the cool things that you can create. that will come out of you. It's like, whoa, I had no idea this was in me. And the process is just so enjoyable for me. I usually have some type of art project in the works. As busy as I am, it's just something that I kind of keep going. Really interesting to see some of these things that are starting to come forth on this painting. I'm seeing at least one face. I'm not going to say where the face is because maybe you're not supposed to see a face if you don't see the face. But it will reveal itself if it's supposed to. Now, usually when I create a painting, what I do when I get to the edges is I actually paint the sides. And that way, if whoever winds up being its owner, if they don't want to actually frame their work, then they can just hang it and it looks, it just gives it a nice finished look to, you know, be walking by a painting and you're seeing the side of it and you're seeing the colors and it doesn't look like just the one dimension.
All right, so now you see part one of my intuitive painting. I basically just laid a nice broad foundation just so I could see what it's gonna start to take shape as. And I still am not sure, but I see some things in it. So join me for part two.